Hello, my name is Adrian Young and I work at Fluke Networks, and I'm going to talk to you about the FI7000 today. If you think this looks familiar, doesn't it look like the CertiFiber Pro or the OptiFiber Pro or even the DSX? It is. It's part of the Versiv family. What makes this an FI7000 is simply the fact it doesn't have a module in the back and it comes with a USB camera. Now, what the FI7000 allows us to do is inspect the end face of connectors, and more importantly, apply a test limit. We can actually grade these connectors automatically to the international standard IEC 61300-3-35. If you're in an area which operates to ANSI TIA standards, just be aware that in the D standard that's coming at the time of the shooting of this video, it's going to reference this same IEC standard 61300-3-35. The TI have just decided there's no point in writing another standard when this standard exists already. So fundamentally, they're going to kind of adopt that IEC automated inspection standard. So let's turn to the machine and talk about how we actually set this up. So, just like we did in all our other videos in this series, the CertiFiber Pro and the OptiFiber Pro, we're talking about configuring a test limit. Here's my test limit. I can tap on it. I can go Edit, Test Limit, and More, and End Face Limits. And I get four to choose from. These are from that IEC standard. The first one here ends in MM. That's for multi-mode connectors. Whether it's field polish or factory polish, you get to use one limit. The next one down on the list here, 45 dB, is for single mode factory polish connectors. The third one, where it says 26 dB, is again single mode, but that's where you're field polishing. And then finally, we have APC, angled physical contact. That's APC connectors. In this little example on the table here today, I'm going to be using multi-mode. I'm going to tap multi-mode, save it, that's my test setup, and use selected. So on the table here, I've got some connectors, and let's see how we get on. So I'm going to plug my fiber inspection in, and I'm going to hit the test key. It's going to bring up the image. I'll just briefly bring it into focus. And now we have to make a decision. Is this acceptable or not? I mean, there is some stuff going on the screen there, but is this okay? I think this is pretty clean. And talking about cleaning, on the table here, you're gonna see a whole bunch of cleaning equipment. Customers often ask me, what's the best cleaning options for doing fiber connectors? My answer typically is the one that works best for you. Very popular at the moment are these click pens, and they're very easy to use, and they're great for getting dirt off. But if there's embedded dirt on the end face of the connector, you'll probably want to go to a solvent-based pen. These solvent-based pens will really remove the nasties that can be on the end face of connectors. So before you throw away those cords, try using a solvent pen. This is actually my favorite. I use this as a backup. So I'll go to the click pen first, and then I'll go to the solvent pen. So I'm connecting in, I've got this, and now I've got an option that says Analyze because I configured a test limit. If I tap Analyze, in 1.2 seconds, roughly, okay, that's the engineer in me, it's about a second, it's gonna analyze that end face to that IEC standard. That's probably faster than you can analyze the end face by just visually looking at it. More importantly, if you were to get five experts in the room and ask them whether they thought that was good or not, you'd probably get different answers. The nice thing about this standard is it says, okay, this is what we're all going to agree on, and if it's pass, it's a pass. And just like any other test that we do on the Versiv platform, indeed, we can actually save this test result. So I can tap Save and save this image. Now, in the series of these videos, we did the CertiFiber Pro for our Tier 1 testing and the OptiFiber Pro for our Tier 2 testing. And in the OptiFiber Pro, you saw how we were able to merge our Tier 1 and our Tier 2 testing together in Linkware. We can do the same with our fiber inspection. So before we walk away from the job, we could inspect our installed connectors, save them with the same cable IDs as our Tier 1 and our Tier 2 testing, and that becomes one concise report in Linkware. So consider thinking about doing that. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to have a look at the end face of this image, and this is going to be my connector that I installed, and it should be nice and clean. Play. Everything looks good there. Tap Analyze. And it comes up with pass. So This could be my test reference code. This could be my installed connector. So what happens if the test reference code is dirty? I'm going to make it dirty by just tapping my thumb on the end there. Let's go and inspect this connector again. Hit play. And it is something absolutely horrible. In fact, if we go and tap analyze now, it's probably going to complain that it's just so bad, you've got to be kidding me. At least try and clean up this connector. So I think we can agree that's a pretty miserable connector. But this could be your test reference code. What happens when I connect this test reference code into my nice new clean connector? That's a physical contact. So now the dirt is going to be transferred from this connector to my nice new clean connector. So if I pull this out and now re-inspect what was a very nice clean connector, it's not clean anymore. That dirt is transferred across. If I tap analyze, sure enough, it's failed miserably. And this is one of the dangers that we're constantly seeing in fiber is people have the clean equipment, but they don't have the inspection equipment. So they assume that because they've cleaned, it's clean. You don't know it's cleaned until you've inspected it. And you can see the real danger here that you could go through an entire installation and damage every connector in that installation. It's really critical to have inspection equipment. So this is SC here. There are tips in the box here to do ST and LC. There are additional tips to do APC connections as well. There's even a tip to do MPO, MTP connections as well, where you can scan across all 12 fibers on the end face there. This, if you're doing MPO testing, you need one of these and you need one of these, because when you clean an MPO, you're going to be relying on this and you've got to get all 12 fibers clean at the same time. You're definitely going to need that inspection device. That's the FI7000. Now, again, I just want to emphasize this. If you have a CertiFiber Pro or an OptiFiber Pro, you already have this built into your tester because it's part of the mainframe. You just need the optional camera.